So, good afternoon, children. Today's class we can start. We already started what is the meaning of the algebra and all, where variables are used and the operations also used and the numbers are used. So now we have seen two examples. If you remember, this means just I'll go back the revision, whatever, just to wind up what is the last class portion. Find the rule which gives the number of matchsticks is required to make the following matchstick patterns. Pattern of the letter is T means how many matchsticks are used. There are two. Already we have seen that 2n is the pattern we are forming. Similarly, Z, the letter Z is used, so pattern became 3n there. Then again, U we have taken, there also you can see another pattern 3n. I told that this is not the only pattern in max we are using. Many other patterns are there. So when we are using the example like this, what is the pattern we are getting there? 2x plus 1. Last time you have seen the examples, we have used the patterns the variables as English alphabet n only. This time we have changed it as x. Anybody wants to write with the a, anybody wants to write with the b, it is also allowed. All the variables of all the alphabets we can use as a variable only. So what is the pattern we are getting? 2x plus 1. I'll say one more example for understanding how the pattern is formed. You know my multiplication table very well, isn't it? Multiplication table, how you are writing? When two tables we are writing, 2 into 1 equal to 2, 2 into 2 equal to 2, like that only, right? So when you are using the multiplication table 2, so 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 2, 2, equal to 4. So here also you can form a pattern 2n, where n is a natural number only, right? Similarly, when we are using 5 table, what happens? 5 into 1, 5 only. Then I'll write here, then no confusion will be there. Okay, then 5 into 2, it is equal to 10. So this 5 multiples table, 5 we are using for one of the multiple and only, but the other numbers we are changing, 1, 2, 3, etc. So this number, instead of 1, 2, 3, I can make a pattern here, 5n. Right, like that we can form many tables, and you know square numbers very well, right? So what are the square numbers? 1 we will write, then 4 we will write, then we will write 9. How we are getting 1 square? That means 1 into 1, 2 square, 2 into 2. Whether you have learned or not, I don't know, but still I'm telling this, 3 square, that is equal to 9. So generally, if we can write as a pattern here and square, the problem is here 2 into 2, 2 times 3 into 3. The n square means n into n. You will understand this concept very well while doing the more examples. So I just gave an idea where we can use the variables also along with our numbers and operations. That is only we called it as a algebra. So very good branch only for mathematics. It is already we are using this one knowingly or unknowingly in our real life situations. One more example you can see. Okay. Students went to buy a notebooks from the school bookstore. Price of one notebook is 5. Munnu wants to buy 5 notebooks. Appu 7 notebooks. Sara wants to buy 4 notebooks. All are having the requirement is different only. The first one is having 5 notebooks, whereas the second one is having the 7 notebooks. Then the other one is having the 4 notebooks only. So how much money should a student carry when she or he goes to the bookstore to buy the notebooks? Actually, number of books is given, that is different only. And what is also given in the question? Price of one notebook. Price of one notebook. Roughly you can make the notes. No, nothing to worry. I'll post the notes in the group only. So price, listen class carefully first. Price of one notebook is 5, but what is the demand? That is different. For Munnu, it is 5, whereas Appu is requirement is 7, and at the same time, Sara is required only 4 books. So, how much money? How we'll get? We will do with 5 into 5, 25 in the case of Munnu, isn't it? Appu, what happens? 7 into 5, it is equal to 35. Sara will get 5 into 4, it is equal to 20 rupees. Like that, the amount will vary.
But the 5, the cost of one notebook is fixed here, isn't it? That 5 is there. So we use the formula 5 into number of notebooks. How we can write 5m? Where m, what is meaning of the m? M stands for number of notebooks. M stands for number of notebooks only. Whatever they want to buy. Then suppose, what is the general formula for this one? We are getting 5 into m, that is 5m only. Correct? So, I want to buy 10 books means what will happen? M will change. That is 5 into 10 it will become. I want to buy 20 books means what is the amount now? 5 into 20, what is the answer? 100. But 5 became there only. But M are changing according to the demand. According to the requirement, we are changing that one. So, M is called as a variable. Clear? M is called as a variable only. Here you read this one. M is a variable which can take the values 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Clear? So, the word which we are learning today, what is the first point? A variable. Last class you learned what is algebra and all. Now, we are coming to the subtopics. The first point you have to learn today, that is variable. Variable is nothing else, our English alphabets only. But what is the case in, what is the specialty in Max, that the M can take, A can take, N can take different values according to the requirements. Clear? So, in all these examples, read that next point. In all these examples, in so far, the variables was multiplied by a number. There can be different situation also. As well as in the numbers can be added, can be subtracted from the variable as seen below also. Okay, now we have seen two type of examples. One is 2n, 3n, 4n, like that we have seen. Another one more example we have seen, that 2n plus 1 also we have seen, right? Or 2x plus 1 also. There are many situations like that. Where other type of algebras also we can use. Algebraic expressions we can use. How that one? Sometimes we have to add. Sometimes we have to separate. Sometimes we have to multiply. Sometimes we have to divide. That means all the four operations is applicable in algebra. So that is only we have to discuss now. Now see the example now. Sarita says that she has 10 more marbles in her collection than Amina. What is the statement says? Sarita says she has 10 more marbles than Amina. Amina has 20. See the example, all of you. See, Amina has 20 means, what is the number of marbles Sarita is having? The difference is 10 more only. So, 20 plus 10, it is equal to 30. If, see the condition. If Amina is having 20, then Sarita has 30. Right? Now, the changes. They are changing the number now. If Amina has 30, then what are the number is having Sarita? Number of marbles Sarita has, it is 40. Because the difference, both of them having only 10 only. If Amina's number of marble is changing, then naturally Sarita's number of marble also will change. So, how we can make it in a equation in here? Means here in algebra. Sarita's marbles equal to Amina's marbles plus 10. Whatever Amina is having, with that 10 more is required. So, Sarita's marble equal to, we are taking as x plus 10. What is the meaning of that x? X can take any value. X is called as a variable there. Two examples here we have shown. One is 20, one is 30. That is Amina's number. So, according to that, you can see Sarita's number of marbles also changed. So, that is why we are generalizing the statement by using the variable. How we are writing? Sarita's marbles equal to x plus 10, where x is the number of marbles Amina has. Suppose I don't have any example like 20, 30 for Amina. I don't know what is the number of marbles Amina is having. So, what we will do? We are assuming that let x be the number of marbles Amina is having. Then according to that, we are forming the equation. We are forming the expression, we should say now, expression for Sarita, that is x plus 10, right? So, the expression x plus 10 is read as x plus 10. It's a lower class portion, x plus 10, you can see and you can read also. What is the meaning that one? 10 is added to x. This is we required. 10 is added to x only. That is the meaning of, okay, that is the meaning of this expression only, right? So x plus 10 means 10 added to x. Now further we can go for this one. The expression x plus 10 cannot be simplified further. Why it cannot be further simplified, cannot be done? That do not confuse yourself. X plus 10 and 10x both are different. I'll read first, then I'll explain one by one only. The expression x plus 10 cannot be simplified further. And x plus 10 and 10x, they are different. Next. X plus 10 and 10x are different only. 10x means x is multiplied. 10x is multiplied by 10, whereas in x plus 10, 10 is added to x. We may check this some values. See that when we are taking 10x, what happens? 10 into 2 equal to 20, right? 10 into 2 equal to 20, whereas x plus 10 means 2 plus 10 equal to 12. Now, x equal to 10, 10x equal to 10 into 10 equal to 100, x plus 10 equal to 10 plus 10 equal to 20. I read some of you not able to understand what it is that. So, what is the case? The first case will be 10x, right? Second case will be x plus 10. Okay, one is multiplication, another one is addition. Now, I can change the value for x anything. Because x is a variable. Suppose I am giving x equal to 1 only. So what will happen here? It is equal to 10 into 1 equal to 10. It's a multiplication. But what will happen here? 1 plus 10 equal to 11. If I want to change x as a 10 only. So what will happen? 10 into 10 equal to 100. But here 10 plus 10 equal to just 20. That is the meaning of this statement. So, when we are multiplying, when we are adding, see the operation according to that we can do, right? So, these situations will come, but don't confuse that both are same. 10x is entirely different than x plus 10, clear? Now, one more example. Raju and Balu are brothers. Balu is younger than Raju by 3 years. That means both having the age difference, how many? 3. When Raju is 12, what is the meaning of the statement? Read carefully, all of you. When Raju is 12, what is Balu? Balu is younger only. So, what is the difference? It should be 3. Naturally, it is equal to 9. Now, when Raju is 15, what is Balu? Balu equal to 12 only. So, suppose we had given the examples 12 and 15, then you, according to that, you are able to tell what are the ages, what is the age for Balu in both the cases, right? So, for first case we told that it is 12, then naturally it became Balu 9 only. Now, when Raju's age became 15, what happened to Balu's age? It became 12 because the difference is 3 only. Now, these are real life examples with the numbers we explained. Now, in algebra what happens? We don't know what is Raju's age. What is that statement? We don't know what is Raju's age. So, we are assuming that x is his age. X is his age. So, Raju's age equal to x. Then what is Balu's age? It is equal to x minus 3. Right? So, we have got an expression x minus 3. Now, go back to the question. 12 minus 3. 9 is coming. 15 minus 3. 12 is coming, right? So, we should write x minus 3 only, not 3 minus x. Clear? Raju's x, that is Raju's age, that we are taken as a x. We should write that x minus 3 is the age for Balu. Now, this expression, x minus 3, how to read? X minus 3, that already you know that. Now, when x is 12, it is clearly explained here. When x is 12, x minus 3 is 9. That means first case is true with our expression. When x is 15, x minus 3 equal to 12. That is also correct according to our expression. Now, what we learned up to this example, sir. Whatever we learned today means it's a variable is the new word you have learned. What is variable? The word variable means something that can vary, that can change. Vary means that can change. The value of the variable is not fixed. It can take different values. Very important thing. I already explained these points while doing the examples. A variable means it is any alphabets we can take. What is the meaning of variable? It can vary. It can vary means it can change. Any value it can take. The value of the variable is not a fixed value. It can take different value. I think the point is very clear to you. What is the next point we have written? One may use any letters. M, L, P, X, Y, Z. Any alphabets I told. Only some of them we have listed here. So one may use any letter to show the variable. Instead of variable means, variable means we can use any alphabets. A variable is a number which does not have a fixed value. Already we discussed this point here only. The value of the variable is not fixed. Now what is the meaning of fixed and varying or changing? See the next point. For example, the number 5, the number 100 or any other number is not a variable. They have fixed values. Anywhere if you are writing number 5, the meaning is 5 only. Anywhere you are writing 100, then what is the meaning? The meaning will be equal to 100 only. That is why these are called fixed values. The notebook question only we have written 5N, right? Or 5M I think. Okay, 5M we have used. Okay. What is the we have written there? 5M. In that, 5 is fixed value, but M is a variable. According to the demand, M value we changed the right. That is why M can vary. 5 cannot vary. 5 is a fixed value. That is the meaning of the statement. Similarly, one more examples you can easily understand. Number of angles of a triangle has a fixed value, that is 3. It is not a variable. If you ask how many angles are there in a triangle, you will tell that number 3 only. So 3 is a number, so it's a fixed value. It is not a variable. I'll ask how many vertices are there. That we can tell as say 3 only, 3 vertices also there. But what are the letters we are denoting? That you can change. A triangle ABC, then ABC letter we will use there. If I want to name the triangle as a PQR, the letters we will use there. That are called variables only. But numbers, if you count the number of vertices, if you count the number of sides, if you count the number of angles, all remains fixed value only, that is equal to 3. Similarly, is in the case of with the quadrilateral. What is the meaning of quadrilateral? 4 side closed figure only, or it is a square, it can be a rectangle, it can be a rhombus. So how many corners are there in all these? You can count and see that it is also 4 only. It is not fixed. But n in the examples we have looked as a variable. That is very clear. 2N, 3N matchstick case we have seen that N is called as a variable only. I think it is clear to you now what are the cases we have used. So M is a variable. For this example only we take 5 is a constant, or we can say that 5 is having fixed value where M is not having any fixed value. So M is called as a variable. So variable and constant. Changing value or a constant value or a fixed value. I understood. I think you understood very well. Now let us see the questions. Now I have some practice questions for you. First question: if each matchbox contains 50 matchsticks, one box is having how many matchsticks? 50. The number of matchsticks required to fill in n box. N boxes are there. One box, how many matchsticks? 50. Second box, 50 plus 50. That is 2 times 50 will come. 2 into 50 or 50 into 2. Right. Now, if 3 box means what will happen? 50 into 3. 4 boxes means 50 into 4. Like that, The number of box is changed to n. So what is the answer? That is equal to 50 into n. Not addition, not subtraction, because it is repeated addition is coming. First box 50, second box 50 plus 50, third box 50 plus 50 plus 50, three times, right? Next fourth box means 50 plus 50 plus 50 plus one more 50 will come. So 54 times. So what is happening there? The repeated addition is coming. So how we'll write that one? 50 into number of box. Number of box is denoted by which letter? N only. So 50n, right? Now the second question. Amulya is X years of age. Now means present age. She is having X. 5 years ago, 5 years before, what is the age? It will be present age will be, from the present age, 5 should be subtracted. So how we'll write that one? X minus Y. Suppose your age only you take now. 6th class means usually you will have either 11 or 12. Let me take with 10 only. So, if it is a 10 now, what is a 5 years ago, what is your age? 10 minus 5 only, right? So, instead of 10, we are having X now. So, how we can write that? X minus 5. So, X minus 5 is coming where C is the correct option, right? Now, if X takes value 2, listen carefully all of you, X takes value 2, then what is X plus 10? What we should do? X plus 10 will be written here. Rough work. What is the X value? It is given 2. In between plus sign is the operation. 2 plus 10, what is the answer? I already written, I am showing you how we are getting the answer. 2 plus 10, that is 12 only. So which is the correct answer? B is the correct answer. Next question. If the perimeter of a regular hexagon is X meter, then what is the length of, some question mixed there, what is the length of its each of its side? One side only we required. Understood? Because total perimeter of a regular hexagon is X meter only. That means 6 side total length equal to X. Hexagon means 6 only. So, what is the total sides length equal to? It is equal to X meter only. Now, what is the question is asked? One of the side, what is the length? So, if it is 6 sides length equal to X, then one side means what you will do? X divided by 6. It can be written in the form X divided by 6. By form, they have not used here in the option. So, which is the correct option? B is the correct option. I think it is clear to you how we are solving the questions. So, like this, questions are coming. In all these examples, 4 examples only we have gone. All these examples, you are seeing that algebra is coming. Variable is there, operations are there, sometimes numbers are also there. So, okay, next question. In algebra means A into B means AB, but in arithmetic, what is the meaning of 3 into 5? Algebra, what we will write? A into B means AB we will write. That means we will make it close, make it a product there, AB. Then, what is the meaning of arithmetic? Even if you not understood this one, but you must know that arithmetic. What is the 3 into 5 answer? 3 into 5 answer is 15. And here the C is the option. Correct. Now, what is the meaning of this one A into B? We have written now 5 into M. 5 into M only. Okay. So, like that, I think, okay, there is an issue with the, which one? It is your... there is an issue with the internet now. Let me try if it is coming okay. Otherwise, next class we can go for that one.
I think I have lost the connectivity. Let me connect first.